So we have derived equation for air fuel ratio with both methods, first by approximate analysis, second by exact analysis. In approximate, we are assuming air as incompressible. In exact, we are assuming it as a compressible fluid. So we'll take an example now here. See here what it said, that a petrol engine has carburetor of 32 mm venturi size. The jet diameter is 2 mm. The pressure difference at the throat is 50 mm of Hg, that is mercury. The atmospheric pressure is 1 bar and the temperature is 27 degrees Celsius. The coefficient of discharge for venturi is 0.85 and for fuel jet 0.66. The density of petrol is 740 kg per meter cube. Nozzle lip is 0, so that Z value, it is called 0. Specific gravity of mercury is 13.6, as we know. Find the fuel velocity, fuel flow, air velocity and air flow. Fuel air ratio considering compressibility into account. So it is clearly mentioned that we have to assume air as compressible. So I'll just write down first the given data. So given, first thing, it is a petrol engine. Obviously it will be a petrol engine because we are solving the problem of carburetor. Petrol engine, so venturi size they are given. So that is the diameter at throat. So that is a D2 is equal to 32 mm. Jet diameter, we can denote it as DF, is a 2 mm. So don't forget to convert this. So this will be 0.032 meter. This will be 0.002 meter. Pressure difference at the throat is 50 mm of Hg. So pressure difference, by that they mean that P1 minus P2. It is given 50 mm of mercury. See here, we have to convert this into Pascal. So how to convert? See here. So we know that 760 mm Hg, that corresponds to 1 bar or 1 atmosphere. So in this case, 1 atmosphere it is given as 1 bar. So we have to calculate what is for 50 mm Hg. So this will be 50 divided by 760 into 1 bar, that is 2.5. This will result into 6578.9, or I can write it as a 6579 Pascal, or I can write this as a 0.65 0.065 bar. Okay. Next, what is given in this case? Atmosphere pressure. Yes, so that is given, atmosphere pressure 1 bar. Based on that, we calculated the pressure difference. So you can calculate the P2 also. So now here P1 minus P2 is given as we calculated 6579. P1 we know, 1 bar minus P2 equal to 6579. We can calculate P2 easily. So P2 value is 93421 Pascal, right? Now next, what is given here? It is temperature is 27 degrees Celsius. So temperature at inlet T1 is equal to 27 degrees Celsius. This I can convert into Kelvin as 300 Kelvin. A coefficient of discharge for venturi, it is given, that is CDA, it is equal to 0.85. And for fuel jet, so that is CDF is equal to 0.66. Density of petrol, it is given, that is a rho F, which is given as 740 kilogram per meter cube. And nozzle lip is 0. I'll continue this given data. The nozzle lip given as 0. Specific gravity of Hg is 13.6. SF, like for Hg, 13.6. So what we have to find in this case, first is fuel velocity, that is Vf2, that is at the throat. Then we have to calculate fuel flow, that is the mass flow rate of fuel. Then we have to calculate air velocity, that is V2. Then we have to calculate air flow, that is mass flow rate of air. Then we have to calculate fuel air ratio, so that is the reciprocal of air fuel ratio. Consider a compressor into account. So we have to go with exact analysis. So in next slide, we'll start solving this problem. Okay, so first we'll see calculation of air velocity at throw, so that is V2. Calculation of V2. So V2 is equal to, we know in case of exact analysis, formula for V2, it is 2 Cp T1 1 minus P2 by P1 raised to gamma minus 1 upon gamma, bracket complete. So here I'll just put the values. Now Cp, that is the specific heat at constant pressure for air, it is we assume it as 1005 joules per kg Kelvin. So this will be 2 into 1005. So always remember to convert it into simpler units. If it is given in kilojoule, you should convert it into joule. If it is given in kilowatt, you should convert it into watts. So temperature 300 into 1 minus 93421 P2 divided by P1, that is 1 bar. Raised to gamma minus 1 upon gamma. So gamma is not given, but for air, we know that gamma's value is always 1.4. So 1.4 minus 1 divided by 1.4, bracket complete. So if I solve this, so under root 2 into 1005 into 300 into bracket 1 minus in bracket 93421 divided by 10 to the power 5, bracket plus 2, 1.4 minus 1.4, bracket complete. So this gives me 107.75 meter per second. Then our next target is to calculate the mass flow rate of air. So mass flow rate of air, that formula is CDA into density of air. So density of air, remember to calculate at section 2. So this into area, this into V2. So in this case V2 we have calculated. Area we know, we can calculate from the diameter. Only the thing unknown here, it is rho A 2. So we can calculate that rho A 2. Rho A 2 is equal to, you know that rho A 1 P1 by P2 raised to 1 upon gamma. So in this case rho A1 we have to first calculate. So this depends on one another. So rho A1 will be equal to P1 divided by RT by ideal gas law equation. P1 we know, that is 1 bar divided by R for air, it is 287 into T1 300. So this comes out to be 1.16 kilogram per meter cube. So rho A2 is equal to 1.16 into P1, or repeat, that was P2 divided by P1. So this will be 93421 divided by 1 bar plus 2 1 by 1.4. So mass flow rate of air, this will be equal to 1.16 into 93421 divided by 1 bar, that is into
16.45 raised to 1 divided by 1.4.
This into area, sorry, coefficient of discharge, that is 0.85 into area. So that will be pi by 4 into d square. D, you know, it is 0.032 square into velocity. Velocity we are calculated as 107.75. So this will give me the value of 4 into 107.75. So this gives me a value of 0.08 kilogram per second. So this is your another answer. So this was your answer 1. This will be your answer 2. So next two bits are to calculate mass flow rate of fuel and velocity of fuel. That will continue in the next slide. So now velocity of fuel at throat, that is VF2. So formula for that we have derived as P1 minus P2 divided by rho F minus GZ, this into 2. So I'll put the values under root 2 into. We have calculated that pressure difference, so that was 6579 divided by 740 density of fuel minus. This will be 0 because Z is given as 0, so this will be 0. So velocity of fuel in this case it will be 4.21 meter per second. That will be velocity of fuel at throat, answer 3. Then they have asked mass flow rate of fuel at throat so that is mass flow rate of fuel. So formula for this, as we know, it is a CDF into rho F into AF into PF2, so that is velocity of fuel at section 2. So CDF they have given 0.66 into density of fuel, that is 740. Area, so that will be pi by 4 into d square. D means df, so that they have given 2 mm, that is 0.002 square into vf2, just we calculated 4.21. so this will give you the value of 0.00645 kilogram per second. So this is the mass flow rate of. So this will be your answer for last bit. What we have is a fuel air ratio. So fuel air ratio, this will be mass flow rate of fuel divided by mass flow rate of air. I'll just put the values. Mass flow rate of fuel we have calculated just now, 0.00645 divided by mass flow rate of air 0.08. So this will give fuel air ratio of 0.08 approximately. So this will be like what, approximately 0.08. okay, this will be your answer 5. If I want to take the air fuel ratio, I'll just you know, take the reciprocal. This comes out to be 12.5. so air fuel ratio is 12.5. So we know that for petrol engines or for petrol, the stoichiometric air fuel ratio, it is 14:1. So 12.5 is like, you know, the, like less than the
stoichiometric air fuel ratio. Less than means the air is less, so that is the rich mixture. So you know that general tendency of carburetor is to provide a rich mixture. As you go from idling range to cruising range, it is its natural tendency that they will supply more fuel. To compensate that, we are using compensating devices. So this is the first example of carburetor sizing. So we have calculated the mass flow rate and the velocity. The next example, we will see the carburetor sizing when we use a compensating device, that is a emulsion tube.
So we have solved the example for simple carburetor. Now we'll see a carburetor with compensated device. So we know that compensated devices are used to reduce the richness of the mixture. So carburetor, their natural tendency is to provide a rich mixture as the throttle opens, but that affects on the fuel economy. So in order to reduce the amount of fuel and increase the air content, we are using the compensating devices. So we have several compensating devices. So first one, that is the air blade jet. Then next we have this compensating jet. Then third we have emulsion tube. So this is the emulsion tube which is at the throat. Then we have a back suction mechanism. Then we have auxiliary valve, and last is auxiliary port. So all their main function is to reduce the richness of the mixture, that is to increase the amount of air into the mixture. So that is the compensating devices. We'll solve a problem for emulsion tube. So as you see this example, so let us read. An experimental exposed to a gasoline engine of 1.7 liter capacity is developing maximum power at 5000 revolutions per minute. The volumetric efficiency is 75% and the air fuel ratio is 14:1. So that is the stoichiometric standard air fuel ratio for petrol engine. Two carburetors are to be fitted, and it is expected that at maximum power the air speed at the choke is 100 meter per second. The coefficient of discharge for venturi is assumed to be 0.8 and that of the main jet is 0.65. An allowance should be made for this emulsion tube, the diameter of which can be taken as 1/3 of choke diameter. Choke means that throat diameter. The gasoline surface is 6 mm below the choke at this engine condition. Calculate the size of the suitable choke and main jet. The specific gravity of the gasoline is 0.75. Atmospheric pressure, that is P atmosphere, and T1, that is at the inlet temperature, are 1 bar and 200 Kelvin respectively. So in this problem, instead of one, we have two carburetors and an emulsion tube is used as compensating device. So let us first write what is the given data. So here we have four stroke gasoline engine. Its capacity is 1.7 liter. So that capacity, that means it's swept volume, 1.7 liter, which can be written as 1.7 into 10 to the power minus 3 meter cube. Next we have RPM, that is given, N is equal to 5000 RPM. Volumetric efficiency is given. Volumetric efficiency is given as 75% or 0.75. Air fuel ratio, that is given. Here it is 14:1. Then there are two carburetors. And it is expected that at maximum power, the air speed at the choke is 100 meter per second. So air speed at the choke, that is V2, is equal to 100 meter per second. Let us continue here. The coefficient of discharge for venturi, that is CEDA, A for air, is given as 0.8. For main jet, that is CEDF for fuel, that is 0.65. Allowance is made. Then we have emulsion tube.
So let us say this diameter is DE. It is 1/3 of, so it is taken as 1/3 of choke diameter. So that will, let us say choke diameter, that is at section 2, that is D2 divided by 3. So I'll show you how it is. So this is your immersion tube. So this is the diameter. What you see here, it is the diameter of throat or choke, that is the D2. Then we have emulsion tube. So this is emulsion tube, its diameter, it is, I have taken, assume it as DE. Then we have main jet. So innermost is main jet, diameter of it, we can take it as DF. So what they have told us, to calculate the size of suitable choke and main jet. Now, next they have given gasoline surface is 6 mm below the choke at this engine condition. So that Z, small Z is 6 mm, or we can take 0.006 meter. Then what is given? SF, the specific gravity is given 0.75. From that I can write the density of fuel. It's 0.75 into density of water, that is 1000. So that will be 750 kilogram per meter cube. Then we have P1 is equal to 1 bar, or I can write 10 to power 5 Pascal. Then we have T1, that is 300. So that is the 300, by mistake it is written. Typed as 200, so that is 300 Kelvin. So it is 300 Kelvin. So we have to find the choke diameter, that is D2, and we have to calculate DF. Okay, so that is the given data. We'll start in the next slide. So in this example, two carburetors are used. Let us say this is a carburetor 1 C1, this is a carburetor 2 C2. So generally two carburetors or multiple carburetors are used where the high power requirement is there. So this will take air. Let us say they have a common intake. So this may be, you know, air filter. Air will come. They might have some common, fuel line also. So this is connected to fuel tank. So this is the schematic, actual medical. Then what they will do? They will do the prepare a mixture of air fuel. Then that mixture will be sent to the inlet manifold. But inlet manifold will supply this fuel, this mixture, to an internal combustion engine. So this may be its inlet valve, or the exhaust valve. This will be exhaust manifold. There will be a spark plug. Piston connecting valve. So this is just one schematic. So we'll start first. So what is given in this case is volumetric efficiency. Volumetric efficiency, we know it is the ratio of actual volume served to the swept volume. So that is the ratio of actual air taken inside divided by swept volume. So we have to calculate first the actual air, that is the actual air at this point. So VA at this point we have to calculate. VA is equal to that will be volumetric efficiency into swept volume, but this will give you the value in meter cube. If I want meter cube per second, then I have to multiply by small n into 1 by 60. So small n here, it will be feet divided by 2 for 4 stroke, or this will be equal to n for 2 stroke engines. So the actual value will be equal to VA is equal to volumetric efficiency given 0.75. into VS, we know 1.7 into 10 to power minus 3 meter cube into 5000 rpm divided by 2, because it is a 4 stroke engine, into 1 by 60 to convert it into per second. So this will give you the value of 0.053 meter cube per second. So this is how we calculate the actual volume. Now there are two carburetors. So I'll continue here. So there are, you see, there are two carburetors. So volume per carburetor, volume flow rate per carburetor. So let us say it is a VA1 or VA through, like, suppose carburetor 1. So VA through carburetor C1, that will be equal to VA divided by 2. So that will be equal to 0.053 divided by 2. So this will give the value of 0.026 meter cube per second. Then if I want to convert it to mass flow rate, so mass flow rate through, let us say, carburetor 1. So let us give it an annotation as simply MA. So MA will be equal to, because the mass flow rate through each carburetor will be same as it is divided. So MA is equal to then this VA C1 into density of air. So density of air into the volume flow rate, that will give you the mass flow rate. Okay. Now, how to calculate this rho A1? Because in this case, as you see, density is not given, so we have to assume air as a compressible fluid. So if I go with this, rho A1 is equal to P1 divided by RT1. So P1 we know 10 to power 5, that is 1 bar, into R for air is 287 into 300. So this will give you the value of 1.16 standard value for atmospheric conditions. So MA will be equal to 0.026, that is volume flow rate, into 1.16. So MA is equal to 0.03 kg per second. Okay. So our main objective here, it is to calculate T2, that is the diameter at throat. It will be calculated from the area at the throat. This will be calculated from mass flow rate of air. Now, mass flow rate of air, that formula we have, is equal to CDA into density of air at throat into A2 into P2. So I have to calculate, I know here mass flow rate, this is also given, this we have to calculate, this is also given, this calculation we have to now carry out. So I have to calculate rho A2. So rho A2, as we know, is equal to rho A1 into P2 by P1 raised to 1 upon gamma. Now here we know the P1, right, but P2 is unknown. So we'll calculate the P2 first. So we know the formula for P2 is equal to, in bracket, 2CPT1 into bracket 1 minus P2 by P1 raised to gamma minus 1 upon gamma, bracket complete. So V2 is given in this case for maximum power, that is 100 meter per second, is equal to under root bracket 2 into CP for air 1005 joule per kg Kelvin into 300 into, in bracket, 1 minus P2 is unknown here, so P2 by P1 raised to gamma, one for air it is 1.4 divided by 1.4. So how to solve this equation? So first you have to take the square on both sides, then you have to take this area, this values at the denominator of 100 square, then you have to solve this. I'll just calculate what it comes out to be, the P2 from this equation. Okay, so OP2 comes out to be here 94309 Pascal, or simply I can say 0.943 bar. Now I can easily calculate the density of air at the throat, so that will be equal to rho A1 into P2 by P1 raised to gamma, oh sorry, 1 upon gamma. So this comes out to be 1.16 into this 94309 divided by 1 bar, 1 divided by 1.4. So this comes out to be 1.112 kilogram per meter cube. So air will compressible in this case, as you see, as the section changes. So previously at the inlet, the density was, we have calculated it as 1.16. Now at throat, that density is reduced because air be compressible. Now next we will put this value in this equation of mass flow rate. So this will be equal to 0.03 equal to 0.8, that is the coefficient of discharge, into density 1.112 into area. So area will be like, I just write only area now. We'll see how to calculate area afterwards. Now from this equation I can get area is equal to 0.00033 meter square. Now from this area I can calculate the diameter. We'll see in next slide. So see here, so that section, if you see closely, the venturi, this is the throat, right? In that there is a main jet. Okay, at the outside of the main jet there is a emulsion tube. Okay, if I see from the top, so top tube will be, there will be a venturi, right? Then inside this let us say throat, then there will be emulsion tube, inside there will be main jet. So this will be, let us say this is a front view and this is a top view. In this, this is your D2, this is DE, and the small one, it is your DF, that is a jet diameter. So here this A2, area of the throat, will be equal to pi by 4 D2 minus DE square. Now in this case we have given, what is given, DE is equal to D2 by 3, or I can say D2 is equal to 3 times of DE. So A2 is equal to pi by 4 into 3 DE minus DE square. This reduces to pi by 4 into 3D minus DE, that is 2D. 2D square will be 4DE square. So this area we have calculated 0.00033. So DE comes out to be, DE comes out to be 0.01025 meter. So now D2 is equal to 3 times of DE, so this will be equal to 0.0375, or I can say 30.75 mm. So this is in meters. So this is the throat diameter we have calculated. So this will be your answer 1. Now next thing, we have to calculate the DF. Now for calculation of DF we need AF, area of the main jet. For this we need the formula for m dot f. Now in this case air fuel ratio is given, so air fuel ratio, it is given as 14:1, so this is equal to ratio of mass flow rate of air divided by mass flow rate of fuel. So 14 is equal to mass flow rate of air, we had calculated it as 0.03 divided by mass flow rate of fuel. So mass flow rate of fuel in this case, this will be 0.0021 kg per second. Okay. Now we know the formula for mass flow rate of fuel. So that is CDF, yes, coefficient of discharge into AF, yes, into in bracket 2 rho F P1 minus P2 minus GZ rho F. So this will be 0.0021. CDF is given in this case as 0.65 into AF into so the density, so 2 into density is given as 750 into P1 minus P2. So this will be 1 bar minus that P2 value 94309 minus 9.81 into Z. Z is given in this case as how much Z is given? Z is given as 6 mm, so that will be 0.006 into again density, that is 750. So from this we can calculate the area. So that area will come as 1.57 into 10 to power minus 6 meter square. I'll continue with this part here. So area, this AF is you know, pi by 4 into DF square, the diameter object. So 1.57 into 10 to power minus 6 is equal to pi by 4 into DF square. So from this you can calculate the DF. Yes, so DF comes out to be 0.0014 meter. So this comes out to be 1.4 mm. DF is equal to 1.4 mm. So this will be your answer 2. So thus we have calculated the diameters for choke and the diameters for main jet. So thus we have completed the numericals of carburetors. So there are various variations in the problems for carburetors, whether it is simple carburetor or with compensating jet. I advise you to practice more and more so that you will get more clarification, and also very you know that practice makes man perfect. So you will solve that problems very easily. I request you to go through the books. I prefer the book by V. Ganeshan. They have very good examples. So all the best. Thank you for watching.